A very good morning. I am Dr. Shobhit Chatterjee, head of the Department of Juridical Sciences, GIS University. This is my lecture with respect to Civil Procedure Code, and I am still speaking about pleadings. And I am speaking about the exceptions to the pleadings, that pleadings should mention only facts and not law. Now, if existing law is being amended within the country in India, in that case also the plaintiff is required to mention the law in the pleadings. The best example can be the Consumer Protection Amendment Act. Now, in this type of act, there has been a number of amendments. Now, one of the broader amendment also speaks about the kind of, you know, third party liability. Now, the liability is in respect of the company who has produced a particular product. It is like the example is, previously under the Consumer Protection Act of 1986, if let's say a defective pressure cooker was bought by a consumer and the pressure cooker exploded, the consumer could only file a suit in the Consumer Protection Forum, that means the district forum, to actually get the pressure cooker changed or maybe some rectified. But in the present law, if the pressure cooker bursts and thereafter the same respective consumer gets injured, the consumer can file a civil suit asking for compensation relating to the damage that has been faced in respect of the body of the person, in addition to replacing that existing pressure cooker. Now, if this part of the law which has been included or inserted under the Consumer Protection Amendment Act, if that is not mentioned in the plaint, how will the court basically know that already the law has changed? Besides, there has been a new body being created called CCPA, Central Consumer Protection Authority. Now think of a particular situation where the CCPA files a suit against a particular company for exploiting the consumers. And let's say it has done something suo motu. That means there had not been any complaint on the part of any of the complainant. CCPA on its own shoulders, being a complainant, filed a plaint. Now at that point of time also, the mention as to the fact that in the consumer forum under the Consumer Protection Amendment Act 2019, there has been a new body being created called the Central Consumer Protection Authority. That body is considered to be a regulator. And the regulator basically has the powers in terms of neutrally conducting investigation to find that if particular companies are exploiting the consumers, giving products or doing something which is absolutely against the trade terms. Because it has to be understood that there was a Monopolies and Restrictive Trade Practices Act of 1969. Whatever were considered unfair trade practices under that act, all of them had been shifted to the Consumer Protection Act of 1986. That included a number of activities. It can be dubious advertisements, it can be false claims, it can be fraudulent, you know, mentions with respect to companies based on which consumers are being persuaded to buy products and services. All these were considered to be unfair trade practices. It has been shifted into the Consumer Protection Act of 86. And presently in 2019, once the Consumer Protection Amendment Act came up, these have been, you know, addressed in a new way. Now is question time. The question to all of you is that pleading should only mention facts and not law. Wherever the law had been amended, in India itself, in a native country, what is the course of action that is being required on the part of the complainant, that means the plaintiff, in respect of filing a civil suit in any of the civil courts in the country? Use up any of the sources that can be helpful for you. You may use the book of Justice C.K. Takwani. You can use the CPC book of Justice Mulla. You can use a my book, Dr. Shobhit Chatterjee, textbook on Civil Procedure Code in India, Thomson Reuters, South Asia publication. Go very deep into the question, because this is a procedural subject. Write down your answers, I'll give my inputs, I'll go ahead with my next lecture.